The Wisconsin legislature officially began its work on the next state budget on Tuesday, when the Joint Finance Committee began receiving reports from the heads of state agencies. Before that could begin, however, Democrat Senator Jennifer Schilling presented her party's opening statement, immediately attacking the governor's proposal for a middle-class tax cut.
We have heard concerns about tax changes that will benefit the wealthy at the expense of low and middle-income families.
Department of Administration Secretary Mike Hipsch was the first agency head scheduled to appear, and he was able to provide some facts to accompany Senator Schilling's statement.
Essentially, it's called the middle-class tax cut because in Wisconsin, we tax in basically five brackets. As you as an income earner move through those brackets, you're taxed at those different percentage levels. What the governor did was recognizing that while Governor Doyle in the previous administration created a new top bracket, what Governor Walker wanted to do is make sure that we are targeting our investment back into the people and providing money back in the pockets of the people who earn it to our lower and middle class taxpayers. Basically, that is really the bread and butter of Wisconsin's economy. And so what he did is he lowered the percentage of those bottom three brackets. The top two he did not change. So by reducing those are not only a change now that will mean in some dollars coming back into their pockets today, but it will be a permanent change, a permanent reduction in the tax rate. That over the next 10 years will equate into about $1.7 billion going back into the taxpayers and back into our economy rather than coming into Madison.
Senator Glenn Grothman also had some thoughts on tax cuts.
We sometimes wonder whether we should reduce the top income tax bracket, and sometimes we're afraid that if we reduce the top income tax bracket, we'll be accused of cutting tax, of helping the rich. But you'll notice from the opening comment that whether we cut the top income tax bracket or not, they'll claim we cut the top income tax bracket, so we might as well do it. Thank you.
The committee will continue to hear from agency heads through next week, after which public hearings will be held in locations around the state. The times and places of those have not yet been released. For the McIver Institute, I'm Bill Osmolsky.